Hey Mustangs!
I'm Mia Garangeli.
And I'm Lauren Canfield, coming at you with your Portage Central news for the week of September 18th to the 22nd.
Lauren, I don't know about you, but I thought homecoming week was super fun. The energy at the game was just amazing, and I personally loved the rivalry against Manawan. What did you think?
Overall, I loved all the themes for the dress-up days. Definitely some of the best themes I've seen in my 3 years at PC.
Although last week was one to remember, let's hand it off to Hamid and Josh to hear what's going on this week in school news.
What's up, Mustangs?
It's Hamid
and Joshua
here with your school news for this week.
To all the upperclassmen out there, there are two major universities visiting this week. First, there is Notre Dame, who is visiting on Tuesday at 9 a.m. And then there is KVCC, who is visiting on Thursday at 8:35 a.m. So please make sure you head down to the counseling office and get signed up for these university visits.
A week from today, the National Honor Society induction ceremony will take place in the auditorium at 7 p.m. Each member of the society will be introduced by a senior member, and each will light a candle of truth after pledging to uphold the values of the NHS. Anyone is welcome to attend. Make sure to come out and support your peers.
Also, to every car owner out there, please make sure that you have purchased a parking pass. Each pass costs $20, and you can fill out the form on the click. Please bring your money, car registration, and your license to the front desk, as they will start checking for parking passes starting next week.
That's all for this week, Mustangs. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Josh and Mead. I really need to get on that parking pass ASAP.
Hey, Lauren, did you see the marching band halftime performance at the football game on Friday?
Yes, it was so good to see their new routine with open eyes.
I know, football games are not the same without that band performance.
Let's see what Peyton and Dave have to say about marching band and their upcoming schedule this week.
Hey, Mustangs, Peyton here.
And David. This Saturday, our PC marching band is hosting their second annual PCHS Scholastic Invitational.
Bring family and come support your fellow Mustang band members at McCamley Nightfield.
18 high school marching bands will be competing at this event, plus an exhibition performance by the Portage Central Marching Band.
Tickets will be available at the gate on Saturday, September 23rd, starting at 2:45. Tickets are 8 for adults and 6 for students.
It will be a late afternoon to evening show, starting at 3:05 and ending at around 9, but feel free to come and go as you please.
This early season show is perfect for our marching band to get feedback, and is a great opportunity for any scholastic groups to put on their schedule.
Let's interview some of our marching band members to see how they are feeling.
My role in the PC marching band is that I am a section leader in the drum line, so that means that I just lead by example.
I'm a drum major for the band.
My role in the PC marching band is that I'm the brass sergeant this year.
I think that my favorite aspect of marching band is getting to see the product improve over time. It's really interesting to just go through that process and be engaged in things getting better over time, and then it's always rewarding to have a performance that goes well.
My favorite aspect of marching band is the people, because we're all friends and it feels like just like a big family.
My favorite aspect of marching band is the people in it, because you get really, really close to them. Like, the trumpet section is really close this year.
I am excited in general because it's always a cool event, and I'll be there either way, so it'll be fun.
I'm looking forward to Saturday because it's our first big performance, first competition of the season, so we get a feel for it.
What I'm most excited for this Saturday is the trumpet breakfast, where we all go to Chick-fil-A and then Celery Flats before the competition.
Good luck this weekend, Mustangs. We can't wait to see you perform.
That's all we have for this week. Back to Mia and Lauren in the studio.
Good luck this weekend, Mustangs. Mia, have you heard what's going on in athletics this week?
All I know is we have some big competition coming up this week. Let's turn it over to Drew for the athletic update this week.
Hey, Mustangs. Drew Kuchera here with your sports rundown for the week. On Monday, the boys' tennis team hits the road and heads over to Portage Northern. The girls' golf team has their smack jamboree at the Moores Golf Course. And the boys' water polo team is home against West Ottawa starting at 6:15. On Tuesday, your girls' swim team has a meet at Coldwater, and men's soccer travels to play Gull Lake, and JV starts at 5, and varsity follows at 6:30. So make sure you come out and support. On Wednesday, your girls' volleyball team will have their first home game of the year, facing Portage Northern. Make sure you come out and support. Thursday, our men's soccer team will be home, hosting Portage Northern in the annual Portage Derby. Make sure you come support the team. And on Friday, we close the week with a football game at St. Joe starting at 7, and the boys' water polo at West Ottawa. For any other questions or information, visit pcmustangsports.com. Now over to Labib for a deeper dive into golf and tennis.
Thanks, Drew. Hey, Mustangs. The end of the tennis and golf season is closely coming to an end. Today, we're asking tennis and golf players a few questions to see how successful their seasons are going so far.
Our biggest competitors this season is definitely Mattawan, because we have kind of a history with that team.
Mattawan, we're both top 10 in the state, so it's a huge rivalry. My favorite thing about tennis is just like the community.
A different dynamic than your usual sport, and I like that. It changes things up.
I think our biggest competitors have been Gull Lake, since they've always been really cocky and our coaches have beef with each other.
Probably Gull Lake and then St. Joe. Last Friday, we came out with the win, and it was a really hard course, but everybody put their best foot forward.
It was really fun, and even though a lot of us didn't feel like we played that great, we still tried our best.
Sounds like it's going to be a good week in athletics. Make sure you go out and support all your Mustang teams. That's all from us this week. Back to Mia and Lauren in the studio.
Wow, that sounds like a big week. Good luck, Mustangs. Mia, have you heard that some of our favorite movies and TV shows might be discontinued due to the writers and actors strike?
I've been hearing all about the strike, but I don't know the big details about it.
Me neither. We should ask Adam and Peyton to tell us more about it.
Hey, Mustangs. I'm Adam.
And I'm Peyton, here with your pop culture segment this week.
There's an ongoing strike in the entertainment world. Writers and actors are protesting production, which has put a pause to most shows and movies being produced.
With the uproar of AI being used in today's day and age, TV producers want to use it with scripts and even create digital versions of actors so that they only come to work one day a week.
As AI becomes more popular and advanced, the jobs in the entertainment industry will become more scarce.
Let's send it over to Ben, who will get us more in depth on this topic with someone who has firsthand experience.
Hey Mustangs, I'm Ben, and I had the opportunity to speak with an actor who is a former Mustang. He gives us his insight on the strike and how it has affected not only him, but the entire industry.
My name is Darius Ledbetter, and I actually tell people I'm an actor and videographer. The studio is kind of showing us who they really are. You know, we live in a world where these production companies make a lot of money, and they don't like to share that money with the people who deserve it the most, that being the writers and the actors. Now, AI can be useful for certain things like making lists or, you know, coming up with a good response for an email. But when it comes to removing jobs, like from actual human people, that's when there's kind of like, that's where it kind of starts to turn a little bit. Hollywood has always been crazy, but I never really knew it was to the extent of like, people really will watch you perish before their very eyes. So me personally, I mean, I'm not incredibly affected because I can still work on independent films and like being able to do production work, you know, I'm still able to, you know, work if there's a project, you know, just hearing how it's affecting him. It's really tough, man. Like, it's just, this is a lot of people's life. There's a lot of people's like daily work, like acting as a job. And for that to just be like kind of taken away, it's unfortunate. People are starting to have to revert to like YouTube and TikTok. Speaking of like your friends or people that you're a fan of specifically, you know, support their work, support their endeavors. If you can, donate to any of the causes that are there, like with the strike. There are ways to donate and there are ways to spread awareness. The biggest thing is just trying to get these studios to sway in their mindset. Because one easy way to get this done, but like I said, it really comes from awareness and people coming together. I would just say, put on that sign what you're really feeling and what you're really thinking, and you know, tell them how you feel.
Thanks, Ben and Darius.
If you want to help support actors and writers in their fight for their authenticity of their work, visit this link.
That's all from us this week, Mustangs. Now back to Lauren and Mia in the studio.
It's so cool that we got to hear from a former Mustang in his firsthand experience with the big strike.
Well, that's all from us this week, Mustangs.
I'm Mia Giringelli.
And I'm Lauren Canfield.
Signing off!